Welcome everyone to my channel, which is Fast and Easy Maths, which is dedicated to give you tips and tricks related to mathematics. So students, today I'm going to show you a trick with which you will be able to do subtraction of mixed fractions in matter of seconds. Okay, this is something which everybody should have known, but unfortunately lot of schools do not show this trick. I don't know why. Okay, so here first we'll understand how the traditional method works. Okay, so here if you look over here, you have 5 1 by 2 minus 3 1 by 5. So basically this is nothing but if you convert this into an improper fraction, so you get 5 is multiplied by 2, which is 10, then you add 1 to it, so you get 11 upon 2 minus 3 into 5, which is 15, plus 1, 16 upon 5. Okay, so then what you have to do is you have to do LCM. In this case both are prime, so we can just directly cross multiply. So 11 into 5 is going to get you 55 minus 2 into 16 is going to get you 32 upon 2 into 5, which is 10. Okay, so then what will be your answer is you get something like this, 23 upon 10, again which is an improper fraction. And please understand, in mathematics we do not accept answers in form of improper fraction, so we convert it into a mixed form. So your answer is 2 3 by 10. Okay, so you saw this was not a very easy method. Okay, the trick which I'm going to show you, trust me, it's going to be like very minimum calculation will be involved. Okay, so here what do you do in this case is, see, please understand, whenever it comes to a mixed fraction, you can write any mixed fraction. So let's say you have 5 1 upon 2. You can write this in terms of a normal method, which is 5 plus 1 upon 2. Understood? So using that method, we can write 5 plus 1 upon 2 minus 3. Put this into a bracket, or you can just take this minus inside and 1 upon 5. This was actually 3 plus 1 upon 5, but this minus will be taken inside. Okay. So then what you do is just subtract the two integers, which is what, 2. 5 minus 3 is 2. And then simply 1 upon 2 and 1 upon 5. Okay, that you have to subtract. Now this is going to be very, very easy because both are primes in the denominator. So we are just going to what? Cross multiply. So 5 into 1 is going to get you 5. 2 into 1 is also going to get you just 2. So 5 minus 2 is going to get you 3, and divided by 2 into 5, which is 10. This is your answer. Okay, so basically how the trick works is you just subtract the integer part and then you deal with your fractions. Okay, so over here let's do this one more time. 8 minus 3 gets you what? 5. And then in bracket you have to subtract 3 by 4 minus 2 by 5. Now again 4 and 5, 5 being the prime number, so we'll just directly cross multiply. So 15 and 4 into 2 is going to get you 8. So when you subtract 8 from 15, you get 5, 7 divided by 20. Correct? So you saw how easy this entire trick became. I mean, the entire calculation was just solved in 1 minute. In fact, in under 30 seconds. Okay? So if you like the way I'm explaining, then please go ahead and hit the like button, because that tells the YouTube algorithm that these kind of videos are important for anyone who's looking for tips and tricks related to mathematics. Okay, so in a way you are helping someone else as well. Okay, so now let's do this again. 9 minus 7 is 2. 1 upon 2 minus 1 upon 3. So this is going to be 2. And 3 minus 2. Why? Because we are cross multiplying. So 3 minus 2 is going to get you 1. And divided by 2 into 3, which is 6. Students, in case you are wondering that what happens when you have to add mixed fractions, then in that case, I have also made a separate video of that, and the link will be available in the description and somewhere on the top as well. So please go ahead and check that video also. It is very much on the similar lines, but still, it's better that you just have a look at it. Also, don't forget that at the end of every video of mine, I put up a DIY question, whose answers you will let me know in the comment section. Okay, you will use the same trick and let me know the answers in the comment section. Now students, there is one exception to this particular thing, is that when you have 7 6 by 5 means a mixed fraction, and you have to subtract a normal fraction with it, okay, or a proper fraction with it. So in that case, what do you do? Okay, this is not, let's not make it 6 because this is eventually, this is 7, 4 by 5. Okay, so what you do in that particular case is, see, normally how do we treat anything when you have not given over here, we take it as 1. Don't make that mistake over here. Here, when there is no integer part, we do not subtract this particular integer with any other integer, okay? Do not consider it as 1 and make it 6. It's not going to work. It's going to get you a wrong answer. So in such a case, we're just going to keep 7 as it is. And then we're just going to start with our normal subtraction of improper fractions. Sorry, of proper fractions. So 7. Then again, now your LCM will be what? 10, because 10 comes in 5's table. So 4 will get multiplied by 2, so which is going to get you 8 minus 3. So this is going to get you 7, and this is going to get you 5 upon 10. Okay, so I hope you are getting how, you know, how to calculate or how to do the subtraction when it, especially when it comes to mixed fractions. Okay, now this is one example where I've taken like big, more than two mixed fractions. So in that case also we'll do 10 minus 7 is 9. 9, 10 minus 7 is 3. 3 minus 2 is going to get you a 1. Okay. And now you are going to get 1 upon 2 minus 2 upon 10 minus 1 upon 5. Now, if you look closely, 10 comes in 2's table as well as 5's table. So here, your answer will now shift to 1. And your LCM is 10. So now in order to make this 10, we are going to multiply by 5. So even 1 will get multiplied by 5. And 2 will remain as 2 because 10 is already my denominator. I don't have to multiply it with anything. And your 5 will get multiplied by 2 to make it 10. So again 1 will also get multiplied by 2. So here you have 5 minus 2 minus 2, which is going to get you 1. So 1 upon 10 is your final answer. Okay, students, please understand, you can also share these kind of videos with all your friends. Okay, so this might really, really help someone who has a lot of inhibitions when it comes to basic understanding of fractions. Okay, so now coming to your DIY. Okay, let me see what we can do. I think we have done that. So let's do something like 5, 1 by 2 minus, let's do 2, 1 by 8. Do let me know your answers in the comment section. So that's it for now. I will see you in the next video.